So, good morning, good evening, everyone. So, I would like to thank FAO and UNWTO to invite us to present about the experience of agri and ecotourists for rural development in Vietnam. So, I'm from Vietnamese Academy of Agricultural Sciences.
That was sorry to interrupt you. Can you speak a bit more close to the microphone?
It's okay now?
Yeah, better. Please. Good. Very good.
Better,
Yeah.
yes. Vietnam is a very diverse country, and the number of tourists coming to the country in the recent years increased fastly. And according to Nielsen Research, 65% of tourists interest about ecotourists and homestay in rural area in Vietnam. Vietnam have a very strong cultural diversity with 54 ethnic minority difference. So this is we can consider as a very rich tourist rural tourist resources. And we have at UNESCO World Heritage site and more than 2,000 craft village with the traditional craft. Also strong diversity of ecological region and biodiversity, and we have more than 100 geographical indication protected product. So in order to improve the income of rural farmer and then diversification of livelihood since 2018, the government using tourists as activities, main activities of rural development program. And recently we promote tourists as one commune, one product as a local service of product. So some information about rural tourists and development in Vietnam. So currently in Vietnam, over the country, we have 1,300 tourist sites, and mostly 70% of tourist sites attraction is in a rural area. So in Vietnam, we have different form of the tourists, but focusing in three main tourists. Firstly is homestay or community tourists. Secondly is ecotourists, and thirdly is agricultural tourists. There are some initiatives of tourist community, professional association, or cooperative, or some collaborative group, or club in different area of Vietnam, in order to attract a small farmer to involve in the tourist inclusive tourist activities. Since 2012, we have a cooperation with Accueil Paysan in France. For this is an organization for rural tourists, and we have already three. Received certification from Accueil Paysan as an official network member. And since 2018, Vietnam is promote strongly the one commune, one product. So for the tourist product in this program, we have 26 recognized community tourists, and we have a rating with the maximum of 5 stars. So this tourist site can have 3 or 4 stars is a medium level, and mostly focusing in the concentrate in the northern mountain of Vietnam. Also in Mekong Delta, we have 7 products. And in the central part of Vietnam, we have 4 products in the different area of Vietnam. But ecotourists and agritourists in Vietnam have rapid development in Vietnam, but it's still new. So still lack of legal framework for planning of rural tourists in the development rural development planning in rural area. and also lacking of standards for agri and ecotourist in order to manage a good quality of services. The rural tourist has not been associated with the integrated rural development, so the problem of investment in local infrastructure is still poor and also causing sovereign environmental pollution or destruction of natural resources. So we have can observe some conflicting natural resource management when we organize the tourist activities and production activities in a rural area. The distribution of profit in the tourist value chain also is not fair. So farm again very small part, while the tourist agency gain a lot. So this is also critical point for improvement of sustainable tourism. The service of organizing professional training for farmer in rural tourism is still gap, and farmer in a different area they need a lot of training for tourist service organizing. Also, the activities of marketing, advertising, and providing information about rural tourism for client and mostly for visitor, because in Vietnam the English is not the main language, so farm doing tourist have facing the problem of communication with directly with international visitor. So now we can see some new initiative of rural tourist. For example, in this slide we can see a village designing for education, agriculture and education tourists, both for foreigner and for children in Vietnam. So the tourists can and practice different type of agricultural practices, and we have a small tour in a village, and also testing the local food with farmers. So in the rural development program, we are now discussing how to promote a better rural tourist and ecotourist in the post COVID period. So the idea of promoting smart ecotourist with supporting of digital tool is coming, and then and Ministry of Agriculture supporting for this initiative. So we can have with the digital platform for tourists, you can have maybe better information for visitor, and also they can win better planning and to understand the site before coming. And also for farmer, they can organize better services and also reduce the impact on environment. And also they can see better the demand of the visitor. In order to ecotourists in Vietnam, there are some policy recommendation. The Ministry of Agriculture and Ministry of Tourism should work together to complete the policy and standard for agri and ecotourists, and raising awareness about ecotourism for the communities as a livelihood opportunity. And maybe we can conduct a survey on the agri and ecotourist resources to build a database and serving for planning activities in rural area, mostly for local authorities. The training for rural and ecotourists into a profession in a rural occupation is also important for the future. And conduct a digital transformation in agri ecotourists initiative that we are testing is building a smart tourist village and facilitating the access, also the access for financing solution for farmer who want to invest in the rural tourist is important, because for small farm and cooperative in Vietnam now, accessing to credit is still a major challenge. So with a very short time, we can have some conclusion for the presentation. Agri and ecotourism in Vietnam is the early stage of the development, but has a great, very rich potential in for the future and contributing to sustainable rural development and farmer income. And agri-tourism, this is a new form, but should be integrated with agroecology promotion. That this is a strategic orientation of Vietnam under the after the food system dialogue this year. Agroecology is promoting, and in Vietnam we have a lot of potential of agricultural heritage, maybe like in China or in Japan, but we are not in the list of FAO, so we require maybe FAO team can also support Vietnam to register some agricultural heritage, and we are very interested about this and for promoting of rural tourists, and we can win ecotourist and agritourist regional network, maybe in the ASEAN or Asia network, for example. Maybe with the support from FAO and UN WTO, and with the support of the digital platform in order to share the experience and also to promote the marketing for agriculture and ecotourism. Thank you very much for.